So next we'll be defining moving loads as per IRC6. So we'll click on moving load option and we'll click on moving load code, select India from here. So this is a two-lane bridge. The clear carriageway is 7.5 meters. So we will be defining one lane of 70R and two lanes of class A. So first we'll click on this traffic line lanes, click on add, and then give the name 70R most eccentric. And then I will just change the units to kilonewton meter. Then eccentricity value will be from the center line of bridge to the center line of lane. So the eccentricity for the most eccentric position is 1.155 meters. Then wheel spacing for 70R vehicle, it is 1.93 meters. Impact factor, I'm taking 10%. So I need to input 0.1 and then selection by 2 points. I need to click on this first box. First, I will switch the view to the front view. And then I need to click in this box. This will turn green. Then you need to click on the first node of superstructure and last node of superstructure. So automatically this data will be fed over here. You click on apply. So this way. So this is the lane which we just defined. I'll just zoom in and show it to you. So 1.155 meters from the center line of bridge. Again, I'll just click on this initial view and remove the display of lane. Again, we will be adding quickly two more lanes for class A vehicles. So I will just give the name class A1. Eccentricity, I will give 2.45 meters. And wheel spacing remains same. Impact factor, I will give as 0.1. And this time, we will be defining the moving load using a different technique. So this technique will be helpful in case you are having a curved bridge. So first I will select superstructure elements and then I will renumber them from left to right side. So I'll right click and go to elements and renumbering. I'll just move this towards the right side. So I will just give element number, starting element number as say 200 and then I'll click on apply. So after renumbering, we will just select the elements again. So these are all superstructure elements now, 200 to 331. I will copy these element numbers from here and I will just paste it. I will go for select by number and I will just paste it in this box and click on add. And then I can just click on OK. So you can see this moving lane is now defined. Now similarly, I'll be defining another lane for class A. So I'll click on add and I'll give name as class A2. So we'll give the eccentricity of the lane as -1.05 meters and wheel spacing remains same. Impact factor, again, I will give 10%, that is 0.1. Again, there's selection by number and I'll input the same element numbers over here of superstructure. I click on add and OK. So this is the second lane of class A which has been defined. I'll close this and I'll go to vehicles and I'll click on add standard. I'll add class A vehicle and then clicking on apply and then I'll select 70R vehicle and then click on OK. So these two vehicles we have added. Now the third thing is we need to associate the vehicles with their lanes. So we need to go to moving load cases. Click on add. So first we'll define 70R. Uncheck this auto light load combination. Click on add. Then I will select the 70R most eccentric lane. Bring it to the selected lane box. Click on OK. And I click on OK again. So this 70R vehicle is linked with 70R lane. Again, I will define the same thing for class A vehicles and give the load case name as class A. I'll uncheck this auto light load combination, click on add. Again, I'll just select these two lanes of class A and change the maximum number of loaded lanes to 2 and change the vehicle to class A and then I'll click on OK and again I'll click on OK. So this way the moving load definition is done. So this completes the moving load definition for this bridge.